Hello, I'm Dr. Robert Bastian of Bastian Voice Institute. If you are having a problem swallowing, especially solid foods and pills, and if that problem is slowly worsening over recent months or years, then this video will give you some information about one of several potential explanations. It is a problem with a muscle here in the throat that won't relax properly to let food through it and into the esophagus. At Bastian Voice Institute, we call this cricopharyngeus dysfunction. It is also sometimes called upper esophageal sphincter achalasia. Now, this is a disorder not well known by many physicians for a legitimate reason. It is uncommon, and they may have never heard of it or encountered it. The problem this may have posed for you, however, is difficulty getting a clear diagnosis and plan for treatment. Now, before we proceed further, let me note that this discussion is intended to be informational. It's not for the purpose of a diagnosis. The hope is that after watching, you may be better equipped to discuss this problem with your own physician. Now, over the months or years, the person will say the frequency of the lodgment of things wanting to get stuck here has increased. It's happening more frequently. And the number of foods that cause the problem is expanding. First, it was pills and meat. Now, even bread sometimes will get stuck here. They'll say, I've generally had to go for softer foods. I chew very carefully. If I'm eating meat, I cut it into very small pieces before I put it in my mouth. Some other people will say, I do a lot of throat clearing while I'm eating. I waken in the night with phlegm in my throat. Sometimes I cough during meal times and so forth. And here's a key symptom for some, not for all. Some will say, I'll be sitting and watching TV and I cough or do that kind of thing and spit, and there I find in the tissue something that I ate hours ago in the tissue. All along the gastrointestinal tract are a series of sphincter muscles. The first sphincter is technically the lips that can pinch together from all sides. The next sphincter is right here at the cricoid cartilage, but it wraps around the food way, which is right behind the voice box. And so this muscle, which is contracted in you watching this right now and in me, when we swallow something over the tongue and down into the throat, it has to open up, let the food through, and then it clamps shut again. It's like a gate that opens for a second and then closes right behind the food. Well, in some people, for reasons that are not always fully understood, that muscle stops relaxing. It won't let go. The gate won't open. Now, liquids and soft foods can still squeeze through because if it's partially relaxed, they can get through a narrow opening, but solid foods less and less. The problem progresses, always gets a little bit worse over months or years' time, and eventually even soft foods and liquids have a hard time getting through. The best single test is an X-ray. The video fluoroscopic swallowing study, or VFSS, often performed with the assistance of a speech pathologist. We can also see typical findings during a video endoscopic swallowing study with a slender tube that goes through the nose and down into the throat, performed at a place like Bastian Voice Institute. And then sometimes it is seen during esophagoscopy performed by a gastroenterologist. Number one, you could choose to simply accept and live with the problem. You avoid certain foods, you wash with water a lot, you chew extra well, and that you just live with it. Option two, you can try various dilation procedures, often done by a gastroenterologist, to try to stretch the muscle and break its grip. And that can often be done if there's not a big Zenker's in, which is the sac or the hernia. Now, in my experience, this is a brief benefit at most, and that benefit gets briefer as time passes and as it's done more and more, people get to the place where they say it just doesn't help. Third option, you can try a newer treatment in the form of Botox injections into the muscle. And I mention this option only for completeness sake, as I don't personally view it as a very good option for most people. Example, it has to be repeated every 3 to 4 months, and the benefit is highly variable. Option four, you can undergo traditional surgery through a small incision in the side of the neck here. The procedure is called cricopharyngeus myotomy. The muscle, let's pretend this is the muscle here, the muscle is divided from its outside surface so that the ring is opened. So now instead of the muscle contracting like this, when the muscle is divided, when the muscle contracts, it contracts like that, so the food can get through. Now typically, traditional cricopharyngeus myotomy through a small neck incision here on the side of the neck requires a general anesthetic, a brief hospital stay. Typically, it's a single night in the hospital. This is still a valid approach and is occasionally necessary. Now here's option number five, which I think for a lot of people is the attractive one. Option five is an endoscopic, which means through the mouth, approach that uses a laser to divide the muscle from its inside surface. So instead of through the outside of the neck, we're now inside the passageway, dividing the muscle from the inside to the outside, again breaking the ring so that it can't obstruct food passage. Now there are always exceptions, but when this procedure is done, about half of our patients are done as an outpatient and the other half with a single night's stay. Now, if you identify with what I've described here, consult with your physician about the possibility that your problem might be cricopharyngeus dysfunction with or without a Zenker's diverticulum. If that diagnosis is confirmed, then he or she can direct you to the most experienced physicians and surgeons in your area to develop an appropriate plan. Thanks for spending time watching this video, and I hope it helps.